There are so many great Google Docs features, but here is just a quick roundup of my faves. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and these are the best Google Doc features for 2024. I am all about saving time when I can, and voice typing is key for me. And it's so easy. From any point in an existing doc or a new doc, head on up to Tools, then select Voice Typing. If you rather not do the clicks, you can hit Control or Command Shift S on your keyboard, but you should see a microphone icon in the top left of your doc. Once you're ready to dictate, simply click on the microphone. If you've not given docs permission to use your microphone, you're going to do that. Anything you say will be typed out for you. Simply click on the microphone icon to stop recording once you're done. One of the best features to come to Google Docs in the last few years are smart chips. Think of smart chips like tagging or at mentioning, but to the next level. You can access the full search menu by typing an at symbol. So with smart chips, you can not only tag people using that at symbol followed by a name, but you can use the at symbol to get information on files, dates, and events as well. To narrow this down, you can either search through the suggestions in the list or enter letters, numbers, or symbols. So for example, to add a date, you could just type in at today, or you could say tomorrow or yesterday, or you could even specify a date. But see here, the date appears. Just hit tab to select that date. Now you've created a smart chip that you can hover over to view the related information. You can simply click on the chip to edit it. Plus, you can head to the settings gear from here to edit the date format. So again, if you want to add a smart chip for a document rather than a date, you're just going to hit your at symbol, search for the document you want to add, and then when you find it, hit tab and insert that smart chip. The cool thing with smart chips is that they're dynamic. So if I were to update this document we just added as a smart chip, this chip will always link to the most up-to-date version of that document. Remember, this works for people, files, lists, media, headlines, calendar events, page components, and more. So if you're referencing an event, you can easily add a dynamic Google Maps location link simply by typing at and then the name of the place or city. Pretty neat. And there are also handy building blocks that you can access using that same at symbol key. Underneath your smart chips, you'll notice the building blocks. Actually, these blocks should be automatically available for you at the top of a blank new doc as well. But if you don't see it, no worries. You're gonna type that at symbol. And here you can choose between meeting notes, email draft, product roadmap, review tracker, project assets, and launch content tracker. Selecting project roadmap as an example inserts a simple chart with your project. There's a status field that you can change, related files, and a notes column as well, which by the way, any and all of this can be edited and customized. And if you don't have a paid Google Workspace account or access to something like SmartWrite, no worries, because you can actually pull up a quick outline of the doc you're working on and make a little summary too. Here's how. Click on the Show Outline option in the top left-hand corner of your page. Any headings that you happen to have in your doc are going to be available for you right there, creating an instant outline for you. Sometimes you'll even have the option at the top to add a quick reference summary as well. And a great collaboration feature of Google Docs is to see the complete version history of a doc. So this is really helpful if you or a collaborator need to go back to an earlier version of the doc. You can. From your doc, click on File in the top left, hover over Version History, and click on See Version History. This is going to open up a side panel where you can see the complete version history of your doc, complete with the time and date of all versions. So if someone did happen to screw up your file and make way too many changes one day, you can revert back to an earlier version. You click on a version to just view it, and then you would restore it right from here if you want. Now, if you don't want to do any of that, you can just click the back arrow in the top to go back to your file as is. There are way too many Google Docs features to cover here, but if you want to learn even more things like templates, automatic captions, and more, I have linked to that video. You can watch it up here, or you can watch my other Google Docs videos via the links in the description below. So those are my top 5 Google Docs features. Do you have a favorite feature? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more content just like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time.